Hello students, today in this video we will see yet another type of numericals based on beta function. Here we are going to make use of the property of beta function which we have studied earlier, which is yet another definition of beta function. It is beta mn, it is equal to integral 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to m plus n dx. We are going to make use of this definition of beta function in solving the numericals. The first one we can see, it's given integral 0 to 1 y raised to m minus 1 plus y raised to n minus 1 the whole upon 1 plus y raised to m plus n dy. This is equal to beta mn. We have to show this. Now how we are going to solve it? Let's see. We all know beta mn. This is equal to integral 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x the bracket raised to m plus n dx. Now we are going to make use of this definition of beta function. Accordingly, we split this integral into two as integral 0 to 1 x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x the bracket raised to m plus n dx plus the second integral will be from integral 1 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to m plus n dx. That is the limits 0 to infinity which are given. We are splitting the integral into two parts. In the first part, the limits are from 0 to 1, and in the second part, they are from 1 to infinity. We can say this as I1 and this as I2. That is beta mn is equal to I1 plus I2. We'll say this as equation number 1. Now, we'll consider I2. It is integral 1 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to m plus n dx. Now, how we'll solve this? We'll substitute for x. We'll substitute x is equal to 1 by y. So, dx will be minus 1 upon y square dy, and the limits they will change now. X we have from 1 to infinity. So for y we'll have, when x is 1 y will be 1, and when x is infinity y will be 0. So the new limits are 1 and 0. So now this I2, it will be integral 1 to 0. What we have is x raised to m minus 1. For that we are writing 1 by y whole raised to m minus 1. For dx we have minus 1 upon y square dy, and in the denominator we have 1 plus x bracket raised to m plus n. So we have now 1 plus 1 upon y bracket raised to m plus n. We have substituted 1 upon y for x, and now we'll simplify this. This minus sign outside the integral sign, it's integral from 1 to 0. This is 1 upon y whole raised to m minus 1. So we can write this as 1 upon y raised to m minus 1 into 1 upon y square. In the denominator we have 1 plus 1 upon y. This will be y plus 1 upon y the bracket raised to m plus n. Now here in the next step, we have here this minus sign and the limits are from 1 to 0. Making use of this, we'll change the limits and we'll have integral 0 to 1. Now in the numerator, we'll have 1 upon, we'll add the indices. We have y raised to m minus 1 plus 2. In the denominator, we'll split this. The numerator here, it will be 1 plus y raised to m plus n upon y raised to m plus n. On further simplification, it will be integral 0 to 1. It is 1 upon y raised to m minus 1 plus 2, that is y raised to m plus 1 into. Now this term in the denominator can be written as y raised to m plus n upon 1 plus y bracket raised to m plus n dy. So this is integral 0 to 1 y raised to this m plus n, and this y raised to m plus 1 in the denominator will take it in the numerator, so it will be minus m plus 1 upon 1 plus y raised to m plus n dy. It will be integral 0 to 1 y raised to, it is m plus n minus m minus 1, that is y raised to n minus 1 upon 1 plus y raised to m plus n dy. Now from equation 1, what we have is beta m n, it is I1 plus I2. I1, it was integral 0 to 1 x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to m plus n dx. And I2, we have this value which we have found out. It is integral 0 to 1 y raised to n minus 1 upon 1 plus y bracket raised to m plus n dy. Now this being a definite integral, as we know, the variable is immaterial here, and hence we'll combine both the integrals and we'll use only one single variable, and hence we'll get the beta m n as, instead of x we'll be using y. So it will be integral 0 to 1 y raised to m minus 1 plus this y raised to n minus 1 as it is upon, it will be 1 plus y raised to m plus n dy, and that is what which is asked. So beta m n is equal to integral 0 to 1 y raised to m minus 1 plus y raised to n minus 1 the whole upon 1 plus y bracket raised to m plus n dy. Now the next one. We have been asked to show that integral 0 to infinity x raised to 8 into 1 minus x raised to 6 the whole upon 1 plus x bracket raised to 24 dx is equal to 0. So we'll go for the solution. We have this I is equal to integral 0 to infinity x raised to 8 into bracket 1 minus x raised to 6 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to 24 dx. Now we'll solve this bracket, we'll split this. We have integral 0 to infinity x raised to 8 minus this x raised to 8 into x raised to 6, we have x raised to 14 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to 24 dx. This can be split into two parts. It is equal to 0 to infinity x raised to 8 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to 24 dx minus integral 0 to infinity x raised to 14 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to 24 dx. Now in the next step we are writing this integral as, this is an adjustment. Integral 0 to infinity x raised to 8 can be written as x raised to 9 minus 1 upon 1 plus x raised to 2. This can be written as 9 plus 15 dx minus. Similarly, this integral can be written as integral 0 to infinity x raised to 15 minus 1 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to 15 plus 9 dx, which is equal to beta 9 and 15 minus beta 15 and 9, because we have the standard definition integral 0 to infinity x raised to m minus 1 upon 1 plus x bracket raised to m plus n dx is equal to beta m n. So in this case m will be 9, n will be 15. So we have here beta 9, 15, and in this case m is 15, n is 9. So we'll have beta 15 and 9. But we have seen in the properties of beta function that beta m n is equal to beta n m. So beta 9, 15 will be equal to beta 15, 9. And hence the answer to this integral will be 0. And that is what has been asked to prove. Hope you have understood these problems on beta function. Thank you.